Child marriage is listed among the negative cultural practices affecting girls aged between 12 to 18 years. In the rural Amudat district, at least 80 girls of school-going age are rescued from the risk of being married off by their own parents. Classified under procuring defilement, the practice usually involves parents or guardians who avail an underage girl for sexual relationships or marriage. Detective Assistant Superintendent of Police Daniel Odongo, who heads criminal investigation in Amudat District, reveals that up to 10 cases are reported every month.
I have 10 in a month. Of course, defilement and procuring go hand in hand. Because of most of these marriages, it is basically from the parents doing it so much. And they did not know that procuring defilement is an offense. But we have always taught them, and we have taken some of them to school. So an average of 10, because at least is on the reduction, but used to be total rampant those other years. Through this sensitization, it has at least come down.
Odongo reveals that majority of these cases are as a result of ignorance of the law among parents, where a parent deliberately forces their daughter into marriage in exchange of cows. The deeply rooted negative cultural norms are also largely responsible for these cases.
Cows has been exchanged, the girl is not even aware. Then from there, a girl has been abducted, they take you to a marriage that you don't know. So we are teaching them about issues of abduction, that it is not right. Let them have freedom of choice. Marriage is supposed to be peaceful. We are teaching them issues of defilement. That girls below 18 years should be at school. They should not be in marriage. Let them have freedom of choice. We have also had issues of aggravated defilement, which is committed by the parents themselves. You have had cases, you know, parents have had sex with their own children. So we are trying to tell them these are offenses. We are trying to teach them.
In Pokotia, they believe that a young girl is good luck. A young girl brings prosperity to a family, and the bride price that comes with a young girl is too much compared to those who marry elderly women or ladies. So you find that it goes back to culture. It is the belief that we need to dismantle the mindset.
Besides fueling gender-based violence, child marriage exposes a child to a number of health-related complications, including, among others, HIV/AIDS, obstetric fistula, etc.
This is practiced as a cultural norm. However, it perpetrates gender-based violence. I want to talk of an example of the female genital mutilation. To them, it's a culture. And yet on the other side, it causes sexual, gender-based violence.
Despite several efforts made to eliminate the vice, police say their biggest problem is people who conceal information from the authorities. Even when these cases are taken to courts of law, witnesses fail to show up, leading to dismissal of these cases.
Issues of witnesses, where we have really had a lot of challenges, making sensitizing these people and make them to go to court, it is still a bit very difficult. So that's why sometimes we lose cases. We have investigated the case as well, but now this people cannot go to court to testify. Then automatically the case sometimes will be thrown off if it has been adjourned for a very long time. Then we end up losing the case.
The police in the district is now partnering with CSOs like Action Aid International Uganda and the United Nations Population Fund to sensitize the locals. The intergenerational dialogues carried out in various areas are teaching the locals the dangers of involving themselves in harmful practices like female genital mutilation, sexual gender-based violence, widow inheritance, among others. Hundreds of girls have been rescued from forced marriages and are reintegrated into schools with the help of Action Aid Uganda. Report compiled by Rachel Nachiwala for the news.